I'm here to give you a demonstration of what exactly an AED is. Now, we can see there's an AED on the wall right over here, and we have another AED. This is actually a trainer right here. AEDs come in all different shapes and sizes. They all perform the same function. And if you put an AED on a patient, it will determine whether or not that patient needs a shock. You don't have to be afraid of it. They actually speak to you and they give you instructions and it'll tell you what to do. So I'm going to show you now. If we have a patient or a person that's not responding, the first thing we always want to do is to call for 911. Now, AHA says that we should perform hands-only CPR. And that's with the training that we did with the commissioners. We did a hands-only CPR training. So while somebody would be performing the CPR on this victim, we would want to make sure that we disrobe and expose their chest, because when we put the AED on, it has to have direct skin contact. This is what the inside of this AED looks like. They're all going to look a little bit different, but usually there's only two buttons. There's a power button and there's a shock button, and it'll let you know when to push the shock button. So the first thing we're going to do is turn it on. So, I'm going to pause it for 1 second, and I'm going to plug the pads in, and I want to show you. The pads actually have pictures on them. The pads, they're not a certain pad that has to go in a certain place, but the pictures are just showing you where the pad placement should be. So this pad, we're going to place right here, and then according to the picture, this pad, we're going to place right here. Now this can be done while somebody is actually performing CPR.
Analyzing heart rhythm.
We want to make sure that nobody
touches
the patient, because we want the machine to determine what the patient's heart rhythm is, not ours.
Shock advised.
This patient needs a shock. It's going to charge. And it's okay to do CPR while it's charging.
Take care of patient.
But once it's ready, and the
shock, now.
Shock light lights up. We want to make sure that everybody stands back. Please, do everybody stand back. Nobody touch the patient. We're shocking.
Shock delivered.
Shock delivered, and we're going to immediately start CPR again.
Again, CPR.
And what you'll hear, if you can hear that, is a metronome. And it's going to give you a beat in terms of how fast you should be doing the CPR. And then after a certain amount of time, after 2 minutes, it's going to tell you to stand back. It's going to reanalyze the patient, and it's going to determine if another shock is needed. It's really as simple as that. What's the very first step?
Call 911.
Call 911. Make sure 911's on the way. So then we're going to disrobe.
Here we go.
Here's the power button. There we go. So go ahead and apply the pads.
Analyzing heart rhythm. Do not touch the patient.
Yep.
Shock advised.
Now, in the meantime, you can actually
charge
the CPR. If you can, yep, there you go.
Stay clear of patient.
Yep.
Deliver shock now.
Okay.
Press the orange button.
So make sure everybody's clear.
Shock delivered.
And then the very next step is to continue CPR.
Begin CPR.
And one thing I want to notice, hear how fast it is? The key to hands-only CPR is to compress fast and hard. You want to be going at least 2 inches in depth, because what you're doing is you're compressing the heart against the spine and your hands. So you're squeezing the blood in and out of the heart. You're actually pumping the heart for the patient while that goes on. So you can hear how fast it actually wants you to go. So they say between 100 and 100 beats per minute. If you don't have a metronome, it's actually the same rhythm as the song Staying Alive. So you can always kind of sing that in your head while you do it.